Not after Muhammad is alien should be the messenger.
What did the Rafida say? So you gotta have a pen and a paper and write. The Rafida say what? Yes, the Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, he made a mistake. He betrayed. Making a mistake and a betray different thing. Right? It is why one of their sha'ir said what? What did the sha'ir say? The sha'ir of the Rafida, what did he say? Abu Ismail?
No.
What did the sha'ir say? Khana al-Amin. This is what the sha'ir say. Khana al-Amin. Look, they named Jibril al-Amin. They say the Amin, meaning Jibril, has betrayed. And he had turned away. Right? And turned away from the small lion. He has turned away from the small lion. That's why the word Haydara, it means a small lion. Haydara, like their last name, it means a small lion. And this was in reference to Ali ibn Abi Talib. And this is also one thing that is used for some people to say that those who have the name Haydara, they are from the, yani the descendant of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. هذا ليس بحق مطلقا. هذا ليس بحق مطلقا. طيب. نعم.
So the Shia and the Rafida is the same?
The Shia is the general sect. The Rafida are the extreme Shia. Let's say, it's just like you say the Sufi, right? In general. And you say the Murid in Tuba, right? And you say the Tijani in Kaulak. And, you know, you start naming them. But the whole group, the Tablighi, but the whole group is the Sufi. Likewise, the Shia. You have those who are extreme. And those who are the lesser extreme. You have the Rafida. They are the Ghulat. Meaning the extreme Shia. And you have, let's say, the Zaydi. The Zaydi, they difference with Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah is not in matters of yani the Aqidah per se, but rather in issues of the fiqh. Mathalan, you will find them, they will break their fast in certain times, but they will not curse at the companion, they will not curse at our mothers, meaning they will not yani take a disposition that the Rafida took. Tayyip. So this is why the Sha'ir he say Khan al-Amin wa saddaha an haydarati, that he the Amin has betrayed. The Amin meaning Jibril has betrayed what? He had betrayed the message by giving it away from Ali radiyallahu anhu, meaning an haydarati, the small lion. This was in reference to Ali. And this is why, barakallahu fikum, a name is very important. A name is very important. Ali was in reference to Haydara, the small lion. And Ali radiyallahu anhu was a brave man. The first child of Ali radiyallahu anhu with Fatima was a boy, right? When he was born, he brought it to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Messenger sallallahu asked him, "What do you name him? What do you want to name him?" He said, "He want to name him Harb. Harb. Ta'rifun al-Harb? Like fight, because he wanted him to be brave." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "No, name him Hassan." The second came, boy again. The Prophet asked him, "What do you name him?" Guess what name he wanted to give him? Harb, because he wanted him to be brave. The Prophet ﷺ said, "No, say name it Hussein." So they were about a year apart. The third one was born again. He came to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet asked him, "What you want to name him?" He said, "The same him. It's the same thing. Harb." He wanted to give him the name Fight because he wanted him to be brave. Right. So this shows that the name has what? Has an effect on a person. So Ali radiallahu anhu was brave, barakallahu fikum. He was brave. Tayyip. So this the term, this why he had the kunya of the small lion, because he was young, and Ali was the first young man that accepted Islam. Khadija was the first lady that accepted Islam. Abu Bakr was the first free man that accepted Islam. Ali radiyallahu anhu was the first young man that accepted Islam. And Bilal ibn Abi Rabah was the first slave that accepted Islam. So he mentioned, now this is the new print inshallah ta'ala. ومن الناس, from the people. He say from the people, خصوصا المشركين, more so the مشركين. من يقول, those who say, الملائكة بنات الله. From those, from the people that says that the malaika, they are the daughters of Allah. From those who say that the malaika, they are the banat, the daughters of Allah. He say, تعالى عما يقولون. Allah is far away, removed and يعني distant from what they say, meaning from what they claiming. قال الله تعالى, as Allah جل على مش in Surah Al-Zukhruf, verse number 19, وَجَعَلُوا الْمَلَائِكَةَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ إِنَاثًا. وَجَعَلُوا, they made, الْمَلَائِكَةَ, the malaika, they made the malaika, الَّذِينَ, those who are, هُمْ عِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ, they are indeed the slaves of الرَّحْمَنِ, they are the servants of الرَّحْمَنِ, they made them what? إِنَاثًا, they made them female. They say they are female, right? They say that they are female. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likewise mentioned in Surah Tur, verse number 39, أَمْ لَهُ الْبَنَاتُ وَلَكُمُ الْبَنُونَ. أَمْ لَهُ الْبَنَاتُ, is it that they ascribe the girls to Allah in the boys to themselves? Am lahu al-banatu wa lakum al-banun, do they ascribe the girls to Allah and the boys to themselves? And why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention this? Is this verse, wa idha bushira ahaduhum bil untha, if one is being given, if one was given the news that he had a girl, he had a girl. Subhanallah al-Azim. And we still, with this verse, you still find it among the Muslims. This verse, you still find it among the Muslims. And for those who, their first baby, it was a girl, and you didn't announce it as a girl, and you wanted a boy, you grab your head down. For those who their first baby was a girl, remember the first news that the doctor tell you it's a girl, or the first day that the, what you call that, ultrasound tell you it's a girl, and you wanted a boy, because every man when they want a boy first. I mean, I don't know. They tell, oh, it's a girl, right? Because you wanted, like, man, I want to have a son. I can bring him to the masjid, study with him, teach him, alhamdulillah, be with him, sit with him in the classes, you know, hear him recite the Quran. I want a boy. But وَإِذَا بُشِّرَ أَحَدُهُمْ بِالْأُنْثَى, وَإِذَا بُشِّرَ أَحَدُهُمْ بِالْأُنْثَى ضَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْوَدًّا وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ. While he is يعني in rage, he is upset, he is unhappy, he hated, he's in a stage of yani, he's hateful at that time. So this is the fact that he was only given the news that he has a baby girl. But now alahul banun, alahul banat, alahul banatu walakumul banun. Now you are ascribing the girls to Allah and the boys to yourselves. And the boys to yourselves. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. ثُمَّ قَالَ تَعَالَى, and then Allah جَلَّ وَلَهِ mentioned, وَجَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ, and they affirm for Allah, مَا يَكْرَهُونَ, What did they hate? وتصف ألسنتهم الكذبة أن لهم الحسنى ويجعلون لله. That they will affirm for Allah ما يكرهون. What them themselves they dislike, they hate. What is that that they hate for themselves?
To have girls.
They ascribe this for to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not only that, وَتَصِفُ أَلْسِنَتُهُمْ وَتَصِفُ أَلْسِنَتُهُمْ الْكَذِبَ أَنَّ لَهُمُ الْحُسْنَى. And they are fabricating lies with their tongue. They are fabricating lies with their tongue to say what? أَنَّ لَهُمُ الْحُسْنَى. To say that they have good, they have يعني the best reward coming. That they have the best reward coming, وَلَيَّذُ بِاللَّهِ. وقال تعالى ان الله جل وعلا هي سي اصطفى البنات على البنين. That they prefer meaning that they prefer for Allah the girls over the boys, meaning that they prefer or they refer to Allah the girls rather than the boys. ما لكم كيف تحكمون. How in the world, how dare do you bring a judgment like this? أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Do they reflect? Do they contemplate? That you hate the girls. You hate to be having the girls. But you're gonna, بارك الله, أَصْطَفَى أَلْبَنَاتِ عَلَى الْبَنِينَ. They prefer the girls over the boys. Meaning they make this for Allah. Giving Allah the girls over the boys. For them is Allah the girls and for them the boys. ما لكم كيف تحكمون. How dare do you have a judgment like this? أفلا تذكرون. That do they even contemplate? You ascribe something you hate for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why. When this alim of Muslim, Ash-Shaykh Fawzan mentioned this. When this alim, he asked to come and debate the people. Of the Nasrani by the ruler. And when he came, the first question he asked them, meaning the king and the ruler, how is your wife and kids? And the whole assembly get upset at him. How dare do you ascribe wife and children to our leader? How dare do you say that our leader, meaning our priest, he has a wife and kids? How dare are you? How dare do you say this? He say, yet you hate to ascribe this to your leaders, to your monk and your priest, but you ascribing it to Allah, the Lord of the Alameen. And this is where the debate stopped, right there and then. So this is why, barakallahu fikum, the person of the sunnah, he is wise, barakallahu fikum. فَإِذَا كُنْتُمْ. The Shaykh Hafidhullah, he says, فَإِذَا كُنْتُمْ لَا تَرْضَوْنَ الْبَنَاتِ لِأَنفُسِكُمْ وَتَكْرَهُنَّ فَكَيْفَ تَنْتَسِبُهُنَّ إِلَى اللَّهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَى. He says, if you hate to be ascribed the girls to you, if you hate to have the girls for yourself, if you hate that you should be attached the girls to yourself, لأنفسكم, he say what, تكرهن, and you hate them, you hate the girls to the point that you're gonna bury them alive. Now, how in the world, كيف تنتسبهن, how dare that you ascribing them إلى الله, to Allah, you hate them so much, these are your own girls that came from your own backbones. You hate them to the point that you're going to dig a hole and bury them alive. Now how dare are you to ascribe this to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَعَ أَنَّ اللَّهِ لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا. Knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't even take a son or ascribe a son to himself. وَلَكِنْ هَذَا مِنْ بَابِ الرَّدِّ عَلَيْهِمْ. But this is in regard to what? To refuting them. وَبَيَانِ فَسَادِ قَوْلِهِمْ. And showing